everyone, I'm Joel Greene, and welcome to Curiosity Quest, the show that explores and creates what you're curious about. That's right, today we are indeed creating, because I got a letter from Chanel in San Bernardino, California, and she wrote, "Dear Joel, I'm curious, how do they make cakes? I was wondering how they make all the different kind of cakes. Thank you for putting my curiosity on your show." Well, Chanel, we just didn't find any ordinary cake maker or baker. We found somebody who creates cakes. That's why we are in Corona, California at Tasteful Cakes, where I'm going to learn to become a Curiosity Quest crazy cake creator. Let's begin today's show. All right, so we are back in the kitchen here with Teresa from Tasteful Cakes. Now, Teresa, how long have you guys been in business?
We've been in business about 4 years.
So how did it all begin for you guys?
It began about 5 years ago, and we were driving to work together. My husband Cornelio and I, we worked down in Long Beach at a bakery, and we were in a car accident. Our car was totaled, and we were both taken to different hospitals. We spent a week in the hospital, and we kind of been waiting for something to open out here that we could work in, and it never opened. So Cornelio said to me, "Why don't we just do it? Why don't we just do it and stop driving?" We knew there were a lot of people out here who've been waiting for something big, high-end bakery. And so we wanted to just take it on, not start small. We wanted to take it on and look like a high-end bakery from the beginning. And our logo, actually, I couldn't find any font that would work for the logo. So I drew it out with a Sharpie marker because that's what I wanted it to look like.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
And we came up with the name Tasteful Cakes. For T is for Teresa and C is for Cornelio.
Very cool.
So that it would be, you know, this is our place.
All right, so I'm curious, what do you call somebody who makes cakes?
A baker.
Baker.
A baker.
Cake maker.
A baker. Or a chef. a pastry man.
A cake artist, a cake decorator, a baker. What else? That cake lady.
So what you're saying is that they can be called many things.
Mm-hmm.
And so today, are we going to be doing upside down cakes or sculptures or something a little bit more tame?
Both.
Both. Okay.
Yeah. A little topsy-turvy that kind of looks like it's defying gravity. And we're going to do a basic round cake.
Oh, just a basic, ordinary, boring, simple cake.
Yeah. And something you can do at home.
So I'm heading over to Cornelio right now.
He's gonna help you set up the cake.
All right, and I'm gonna see you in a bit.
Okay.
All right, don't
I'll
go anywhere.
Okay.
I bet you didn't know that making cake sometimes requires power tools. All right, so Cornelio.
Yes, ma'am.
You have a rather big knife right here.
That's a big special tool.
That's wow. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna set that down. I'm not qualified to handle that. All right, so we're gonna set the cake up or set the cake?
Yes, sir.
To put the cake down.
Put it on the table to stack it.
Set a cake, put it in the oven.
To let it, usually I think it means to like let it sit and kind of set up. like when you bake something, you kind of let it set up and kind of blend together and everything.
Do you cook?
Yeah, I've cooked before.
Now we're gonna set the cake, put the cake together. This is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna put my hand on top of the cake, and I'm gonna get really nice and easy with these two. But this one, we're gonna put right here, right in the middle.
Oh.
So
you cut it and you flipped it over, and now you put the top on the bottom's backside.
That's it. And then you're gonna cut the other one right here.
Okay. Wow, you made that look so easy and clean. So just like this, right here?
Yes, yeah, just go like bam, bam, back and forth, back and forth.
Back and forth.
Uh-huh.
I think I'm doing good.
Yeah, that's it. Just go back and forth.
I cannot believe that is the cleanest thing I've ever done, ever. And I'm putting the
only that one. We're not gonna use that one. We're only gonna do 3 layers of cake and 2 layers of filling. So we're not gonna need this one.
So I can eat that later?
Oh, that's all yours.
Oh.
Just make sure you have a cup of milk or something. And we're gonna start with this one right here.
Whoa.
What is your favorite kind of cake filling?
Probably, I guess chocolate. I'll go with chocolate.
Ice cream. Chocolate. Raspberry.
Cherries.
Strawberry. And banana.
So we're gonna get this back.
Uh-huh.
And
all right.
This cake, actually, we're gonna do cookies and cream.
Cookies and cream?
Cookies and cream.
Oh, is this what this cream is for?
That's the whipped cream.
Mm-hmm. Sorry. I'm getting excited.
So we're gonna fill this bag with the whipped cream. Mm. You're gonna do the other circle?
Oh, yeah. Show me how you do it.
So, I'm gonna do like little tiny circle right here.
Oh, that looks like a big, huge circle.
Okay.
Tiny.
And then we're gonna do a little bit, tiny bit here.
Oh, wow.
We're gonna get the cookies right here.
Oh, you didn't tell me you literally have cookies and cream here. Oh.
Uh-huh. All yours.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So this, thanks. Watching me? Okay.
She didn't see. She didn't see. She's talking, so she didn't see us.
Keep looking. Mm. Don't look for you.
So, even with the cookie, I have to watch your hand again.
Mm-hmm. You didn't tell me that. Well, I better eat one more. Just can I dip it in the...
Go ahead.
Oh. Mm.
But this is what I do when nobody's here, like, okay. Time out.
I feel like a doctor. Yeah. All right. All right. I am ready to perform. All right, so what are we doing with these Oreos then?
Okay, here, this is what I want to do. We're gonna break the cookies, and we're gonna put the chunks here.
Oh, wow, those
here
are
and
like
there.
Little chunks.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yes, because you can chop them out with a knife, but they'll be too crumbly. So you want, actually, when they cut the cake, get one of the chunks.
Oh, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, that's, they're gonna love this.
Oh, yeah, look at that. So, and then I'm gonna smash the cookies a little bit and the filling.
Oh, yeah.
So the cake don't be too high, don't be too tall, right here. For a little bit more on top of the cookies, right here.
Oh, this is killing me here. Wow, look at that.
Okay, right here, I'm gonna go right here.
Yeah. You really get in there too. I mean, you're like in there.
So, and then that layer is already set.
Yeah, so it's set.
Yes, so you're gonna put the other cake on top of the filling.
Like this? Or
you can just go like that, straight, go like that.
Just like that?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's like a big cookie.
Mm. Oh, yeah, that's the way. Mm-hmm. Mm. So you're gonna smash a little bit of the cake, and that's it.
Okay,
and then
I'm ready to get in.
Huh? Yeah.
All right, so am I pushing?
Yes. No, actually, you're not gonna push it. You're gonna flip the other layers on top of the okay, go ahead.
Yeah.
And then you're gonna press it, that's it.
And then now, what do we do?
Okay, now, this is what I'm gonna do. Mm. I'm gonna, do you see all the cream and the edges?
Oh, I certainly do.
I'm just gonna.
Oh, there you go.
Smash again the cake.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so this is.
Okay, and just like that?
Mm-hmm. And mostly a lot of times, you know, when we grab a cake or a wedding cake, we spread our hand, so we get more control on the cake.
Okay. All right, Carnegie, I'm heading over to Teresa. Right?
Okay.
All right.
Here's your fun fact.
The largest cake created was 58.8 tons and was in the shape of Alabama. Man, I'm hungry.
All right, so I've made my way back over here to Teresa, and we're going to be icing our creation.
We go through about one a day, and on Saturdays, a couple of them.
Wow, yeah. That's a lot of buttercream.
It's a lot.
Wow. And this is your own secret recipe?
Mm-hmm, of course.
Okay.
Okay, that's about right.
Is that enough?
Yeah, that's enough.
Okay, do I leave this in here?
Yeah, leave it in there.
All right.
There's a spatula for you.
Thank you.
See how strong your muscles really are. Yeah. We're gonna put some red food coloring in, and red takes a lot of food.
Oh, well, don't you have a beater or something like that?
That's you.
I mean a mechanical beater, not a...
Oh yeah, but we use that for the big batches, not like little things. We just mix up.
Big
And it
batches.
Builds up your muscles so you can lift cakes.
All right, so just like, is that a good glob or too much?
Put that on top and do another one too.
Oh wow, okay, I thought I was being...
Yeah. Okay, so now you're gonna spread it back and forth.
That's it. I saw him doing that earlier. So am I ready to...
Go on to the sides. You gotta cover the sides too.
So now do I pull this off or what
just
do I do?
Keep going straight out. In a bakery like this, we do probably, like on a Saturday, we might do between 50 and 60 cakes.
Oh my goodness.
And so...
Oh my goodness.
A cake like this, we want to get it iced in under 5 minutes.
It's good.
That looks great.
Wow.
That looks great.
That's perfect.
Yeah.
That looks like a hat, like a top hat.
Mm-hmm. Just about.
What do we need?
I'm going to have you mix up some fondant.
What is fondant?
I think fondant is a type of dessert. Cake? Ice cream.
Fondant, it's a type of fondue.
Cake? It's a waterfall.
Edible clay, or an edible Play-Doh. Ooh,
fondant?
Yes.
Fondant?
Fondant.
Fondant. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right.
And we buy it already made, and then we mix color into it. And anybody can buy this at any craft shop.
What color are we doing again?
Black.
Yeah, I was gonna say it looks black.
Yeah, that's gonna do it.
Because it is.
And so you're gonna just mush it in with your hands. It's gonna get all sticky and gooey.
Oh, can't believe we're actually gonna eat this, put it on the cake and eat it. It looks kinda, you know. It's
very, so you got a little
bit. Am I pulling the black?
You're doing good. Okay, you got it flat. By rolling it, we just want it to get even and thin it out a little bit.
Okay, now is it okay that it's in a unique shape?
No, it doesn't matter. We're gonna cut some circles in it.
That is incredible.
Yeah.
I mean, look at that.
What do you think?
That's art. I mean, really, that is art.
Here's your fun fact.
Flour is a powder made of cereal grains, seeds, and roots. I mean, doesn't everybody know that? Why are we even telling them this?
And now we're gonna show you how to make some art, right?
Okay, do you see this cake right here?
Yes.
We call it like kind of slanted.
Yes.
So this cake, we're gonna do the same angle in this cake right here.
Oh, the one sitting right here. So we're gonna slant that.
We're gonna slant it, and we're gonna set the cake. We're gonna cut this part, and we're gonna set the cake after we finish it and top it there.
Whoa.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna try to the knife come to right here, like pretty much like in the middle.
Now, when you say try, what happens if you miss?
I won. Back and forth. Back and forth.
Looks like you're gonna make it. Looks like you're gonna be good.
Okay. We're gonna ice this cake with the white buttercream. See, I'm gonna try to spread this icing right here, the buttercream.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And then I'm gonna put my hands from here. And I'm gonna flip it over to me right here.
Oh, wow.
There we go. And then I'm gonna put it like right in the middle. And I'm just gonna press it right here.
So that's like a strawberry filling?
That's a strawberry mousse.
Strawberry mousse. Ooh, look at that.
Yes.
No, so now you have a, wow. Okay.
Yes.
It was funny, when we shut the camera off a minute ago, he was telling us about this wedding cake that he created, which I thought was hilarious. It's a upside down cake. Apparently it kind of looks like this. Like, right? So you had a very small base.
There was like a 6, 8, 10, 12, and 14.
So what
that was like a
upside down cake.
Upside down cake.
Wedding cake.
A wedding cake.
What was funny was not so much the cake, but he had to deliver it to a place that was
in Temecula.
In Temecula, that was on a bumpy road.
So when they say, okay, this is the address. So when I was crossing the field, I said, oh my goodness, what's going
it's
on here?
Dirt road, right?
Dirt road. So it was like,
go.
So, but you know what?
You made it.
We made it.
Oh, you're gonna cut, ooh, be careful.
Go there, and that's it. And then
you're cutting into the cake.
Cutting into the cake.
Oh, I was wondering how you were gonna put that cake on this cake.
Okay. So you're just gonna...
I'm gonna get this part right here.
Ooh, careful now. That's...
And then I'm gonna flip it over, right here.
Wow.
This is the cake, that part, it's gonna go against right here.
Okay.
Against that part.
Wow, how are you gonna get it off that platter?
That's the trick.
Okay.
So we're gonna... This is my level. So I'm gonna measure the legs and the plate we're gonna put on top of the cake to support this cake.
Oh, so we're putting legs in here?
In a plate.
Or like these things right here, these bases?
Yes. So those are what we're gonna stack inside the cake to support the second tier.
I thought you were just gonna put it on top. I was thinking it might sink, right?
So I'm just gonna go right here.
You're just gonna push?
Gonna push.
All right, go for it. You can do it. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's good.
Right there.
A glue? A glue?
Yes.
Like real glue?
Real glue.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Because this one has a cardboard and this is a plastic, so we're gonna put those things together.
Oh, okay. There's cardboard, just wanna make sure everybody knows. There's cardboard underneath the cake.
So we're not gonna sit that glue on top of the cake. So this is a cardboard.
Cardboard under bottom, yeah. Mm-hmm. You see the cardboard under here? All right, so we're setting the cake.
Yes, we're gonna go right here.
Oh, that's good. Yep. Right, you kept the glue in the middle. Wow.
Okay. Right there.
Wow. Wow. Whoa.
That's it.
Whoa.
How do you stack a cake?
You get, I guess, stands, sticks to put them on.
Put it layer by layer. One by one.
You put it on top of another cake.
Just by setting it on top of each other.
So, Teresa, this is what we're creating?
This is what we're creating.
Mm-hmm.
I made that one other time, and so I thought it would be a fun, colorful one to do.
Wow.
This is just the backdrop. This is the backdrop for all the fun. And it was the first birthday, and so they wanted something really fun, so that's when I came up with the different size balls and to make it really playful.
Now, are these balls like cake?
They're actually rice cereal treats compacted into balls and iced with buttercream.
Wow.
Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is make the balls that go on top because those have to set.
Okay.
Because we're gonna make them out of marshmallow.
Ooh.
So we're gonna melt the marshmallows.
In fact, wait, it's gonna be so quick. It's gonna be done before your eyes. Ready? Bam, look at that.
Mm. And add the rice cereal and a little bit of butter and then mush it.
I love your style. I love it.
Mushing it.
Cookies and cake and now marshmallows.
Yeah.
Here's your fun fact.
According to food historians, the ancient Egyptians were the first very good cooks.
I'm gathering some up for you. And you're
here.
You can take that.
Oh, there we go.
Mush it into a ball because we want it to fit inside of this.
Wow.
Okay, let's see.
Yeah, I was being nice. You're beating it.
Yeah,
oh,
so that's gonna, this is big ball-shaped pan.
Okay.
So we're gonna go ahead and smush it into
in the bowl, right?
One half of the ball. We're gonna take this apple core, we're gonna cut a hole down in the middle of here.
Yeah.
Ready to roll.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay, we're gonna roll out some more fondant here.
All right, I'm on
it. And you already know how to do that. There's your little bag of cornstarch.
All over it now.
We're gonna cut out some dots and some rings so we can make some different kinds of decorations on the top.
Ooh.
Well, that's beautiful.
I'm looking at it thinking.
You are impressed with yourself, aren't you?
I'm telling you, it's bringing a tear to mine. That's good.
That looks great.
That looks really good.
Okay. So I'm gonna add some swirls to the cake, to the bottom, so we can tie in the colors.
So easy. Oh my goodness.
Let's do some borders.
Okay. What color?
We're going to use all of these colors here.
Oh wow. Okay.
So they'll look like little
kisses.
Oh my
goodness. You do that all the way around?
Uh-huh. Alternating the colors.
Wow.
So it looks really fun. And there we go. We got all the borders done. It's great.
What are you going to do with these?
So these I'm going to place on top of here. If you could hold on to that for just a minute.
Okay.
This is the first one I'm going to put on. And I've already...
Turning away from temptation. Uh-oh.
So we're going to... I have this one in the freezer so I can actually pick it up and hold it.
Wow.
And I'm just going to put it in the top here.
Oh my goodness.
And put it like that. Put it in here.
Put it in sideways.
Put it in a little bit sideways.
So kind of to support this one, right?
Yeah.
Oh my
right
goodness.
In here.
We're not gonna squish the cake, I hope. Oh my goodness.
Filling down in here.
Oh my goodness.
Tap it.
Just tap
see,
it.
We made them smooth, and now we're gonna give them a little texture.
And then we have this tray of little.
Those are little fondant balls.
Uh-huh.
And we're just gonna accent with those. We're gonna put those all over the cake to just make it more playful. That is great.
And look at it. See, you were questioning about it being art. I'm getting a little bit of. It's a sweet, I don't know what exactly it is, but it's...
a glue, it's a sweet glue.
It's an edible glue.
Here's your fun fact.
The tallest sculpture made out of chocolate was over 20 feet tall and took over 30 hours to make. Tastes yummy.
Okay, so let's see. This is for Dawson, and he's turning 2. So we'll put a 2 here.
Are you talking about my son, Dawson?
Yes.
This is for my son?
Yes, isn't he turning 2 this weekend?
Get out of here! Are you serious?
You think he'll like it?
Oh my gosh, he's a ball fanatic! What are you kidding me?
Really? So you can play catch with him?
I'm not playing catch with him with these. Wow, this is totally awesome. Well, thank you.
You're
oh my gosh.
Welcome.
All right, so thank you very much.
You're welcome.
This is a very, very cool surprise here. So let me ask, now that you've helped me to create a masterpiece for our home, can I help you finish creating your masterpiece for somebody else's home?
We'll see.
All right, we are at day 2 at Tasteful Cakes. It's a Friday, and apparently things are hopping. We're out in their lobby. We're about to go in the kitchen. Let's find out what's going on in the kitchen today. I can't believe they invited me back for another day. Hello. How you doing this morning?
Good,
good. What are you making right now?
I am making some flesh-colored buttercream so I can make a baby out of these two.
You mean like a baby?
That kind of baby. Uh-huh.
Wow.
Yeah, for a baby shower.
Okay. You're just at the beginning stages right now,
yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Hi, Becky.
Hi. It's just going to be a store cake. I'm not sure what it's going to be yet.
Just an ordinary store cake.
I kind of wing it. Yeah.
And look at all these orders right here. We don't want to get too close on the orders, but look at the orders. Oh, my goodness. All right. When we were here the other day, you didn't let me play with any of that.
Because you don't ask me. What about now? You ask, I will let you taste it.
Okay.
Oh, yes.
Well, I'm going to ask now. It's 10 o'clock in the morning. Let me have some chocolate and caramel.
Please do. Yes, I'm going to grab a cupcake.
Okay.
And I'm going to let you put some of the swirl on top of the cupcake. So you can enjoy yourself.
I will do that. In the meantime, let me talk to the guys behind you.
Right.
What's your name?
Chris.
No, Chris, what are you working on today?
My basically job is set up the case for Winnie's or any birthday cake.
About how many cakes have you set up this morning already?
It's all those.
All like, of these?
Yeah, like 6, 8, 10, 12, like 20, 20 already.
Wow. Now, did you come in about 7 as well?
Yeah, 7 in the morning.
All right, keep up the good work and head on to the back here. I got some mixing going on back here.
I'm making buttercream.
He's making buttercream?
Yeah.
All right, look at this guy. Look at him. He's in it. He's in it.
Even on top of the, even in the chocolate.
That's a beaut.
I'm just gonna let you do 2 cupcakes.
Just so?
Just 2?
Yes,
okay.
2. All right. Oh, I need to hold it, don't I?
Yes. You can make it higher. Oh, look at that.
There you go.
I go around the side. Oh,
So you said drizzle.
Yes.
So I'm just drizzling.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
So to really make it.
You can always push it a little bit. Oh my goodness.
You can use
Thank
that.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, that's like thick.
Just be easy on that one.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna go simple on this one.
Mm-hmm. And you can always
squish it. Yeah, squish it. There we go. This would be a really good time for me to wrap up before I consume these. So I sincerely want to thank you, Cornelio. I want to thank Teresa and everyone here at Tasteful Cakes. And I especially want to thank you, Chanel, for sending us on today's Curiosity Quest. Because of you, I get to eat a lot. Now, if there's something that you're curious about, let me know. Go to curiosityquest.org, click on the Send Us On A Quest link, and simply tell me what you're curious about. And it could be you that sends us on our next tasteful adventure. Now remember, every great adventure begins with just one person's curiosity. So I wonder, as I'm about to consume these tasty cakes, what are you curious about? I'm Joel Greene, and I'll see you next time. All right, I feel kind of selfish eating both of these, but I'm okay with that. So I will eat both of these, and I don't know what you're gonna eat. Look at that, I'm gonna go over the caramel crack.
That was a really great idea.
Uh-oh.
To put more caramel on top of the chocolate crumb.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll keep it in mind,
mm-hmm.
and for sure in the future,
mm-hmm.
I will take that idea and put more cupcakes in my chart.
You can use that.
If you'd like to order a copy of this episode or a previous episode, visit us at www.curiosityquest.org. The cost is $19.95.